Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2006, guys. The given question is the 2 power n vertices of graph G corresponds to all subsets of a set of n size n. For n greater than or equal to 6, two vertices of G are adjacent if and only if the corresponding sets intersect in exactly two elements. The number of vertices of degree 0 are. Okay, so this question seems to be a bit interesting, right? Yes. So the thing which he given in the question is the 2 power n. Okay, so I think there are 2 power n vertices in a graph G. So 2 power n vertices are there. Okay. G corresponds to all subsets of set of size n. Okay, so basically, okay, so now I'm getting some idea. For n greater than or equal to 6, okay. So let us take a small example, guys. So let us take 6 only. So it is a nothing but 2 power 6, right? Yes. So what is the exact value of 2 power 6, guys? It is a nothing but 64, right? Yes. So there are a total of 64 vertices, okay. And each of this vertex is a set of 6 numbers, guys. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is one set. So in that way, each and every vertex is a set. That's what he told, right? Yes. Okay. And he told that two vertices of G are adjacent if and only if they are intersecting at least with two elements. So if this is one set and the other set is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So at that time, this 5, 6 and this 5, 6 are matching and that's an intersection, right? Yes. So there are exactly two elements in this situation, right? Yes. Hence, there will be an edge in between these two guys. So that is the concept here. And now what they are asking is the number of vertices of degree 0. So how many vertices will be there with degree 0 is the question. Okay. So I think if we reduce this question to a bit smaller, it could be easy. But that will be a bit risky, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, so first of all, let us try to analyze a few things, guys. Okay, so did he clearly, what is the range of these values, guys? So just give me a second, I'll be checking this word, guys. What is the, why did he start with the? Just give me a second. Okay, so he started with the only. Okay, yes, and it's a chain question, guys, to be clear. Okay, so this question is a continuation for this as well as three questions. Oh my God. That's really good, right? Yes, this video will be a bit lengthy. Okay, so let me check what is the next question also. So the next question says that what is the maximum degree of a vertex in G? Okay, so there he is asking about the maximum degree possible. Okay, and what is the next question saying? Next question says that the number of connected components. Okay, and after that the question is different. Okay, so this question seems to be a bit interesting and a bit complex also as well, right? Yes. Okay. So basically, if you observe the question carefully, so he told that up to size of n. So basically the size of n is a 6 only, right? So at that time up to 5 and 6 only it will be available. So basically these values will not be available, right? Yes. So with that understanding, I think we can analyze a few things. So basically if our graph is containing only these subsets, so whenever you write some values which are always lesser than or equal to 1. So basically if a set is completely empty or if a particular set is having only 1-1 elements, guys. Okay. So 1-1 elements. So it will not even match, right? So compulsory there will be no connection in between them. Means indirectly they are going to be some isolated vertexes, right? Yes. Because if a particular set is having 1 and 2 inside that set, so again 1 and 2 will be in some other set somewhere, right? Somewhere in the whole 64 vertices, some other vertex will have 1, 2 again. So at that time, these two will connect. So basically the vertices which will not connect are nothing but the vertices with exactly single elements and the empty vertex. So how many vertices? So these will be exactly n, right? So if we are having 100 elements, so it will be 100 individual sets. Here we are having 6 elements, so it is 6 individual sets, right? Yes. Okay, and plus 1. So it is indirectly n plus 1, right? So this is a quite interesting question, right? Yes. So he has checked about our logical thinking also, right? I like the question, right? Yes. Okay. So now let us go through the next question. Okay, so the next question is also a continuation question, so I'll be continuing here itself, guys. So now what they are asking is, what is the maximum degree of a vertex in the graph G? Okay, so if you recall, so we need to have at least 2, right? Or exactly 2, please recall it. So we want exactly 2, right? Only then we are going to connect it. Okay, so it's here also, my bad. Okay, yes. So when it is exactly 2, we will connect that set. Okay, so if you recall carefully, so assume that we are having a set which is having all elements, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So let us take this 6 only as a standard case. Okay, so at that time, how many different combinations will be there, guys? So if you are having 1, 2, it will match. If you are having 2, 3, it will match. If you are having 3, 4, it will match. If you are having 4, 5, it will match. If you are having 5, 6, it will match. If you are having 1, 6, it will match, right? Yes. So in this way, there will be various combinations, right? Yes. Okay. So for easy understanding, let us try to substitute the n value in the options and get the values first. Okay. So based on that values, we can decide whether we can calculate in this way or not. Because if there are a lot of values, it will be really tough, right? Yes. Okay. We can apply some formulas or tricks also. Let us see. Don't worry. Okay. Yes. So the first option says that, is it a repeated thing? Just give me a second. I'm cross-checking it, guys. Yes, it's a repeated thing. Okay, so it is a 2 power n by 2, right? No, it's not repeated, guys. My bad. Okay, it is a 2 power n by 2 into 2 power n by 2. Oh my god. That's a bit crazy, right? Yes. Okay. So let us start. So it is a 2 power 3 into 2 power 3. Okay. So what is a 2 power 3, guys? It is a nothing but 8, which is a nothing but 8 into 8 is equals to 64. So this is what option A says. When it comes to option B, it is a nothing but 2 power, okay? So it is a nothing but 2 power n minus 2. That is a nothing but 2 power 4, which says 16. And when it comes to option C, it says 8 into 3, right? Yes, which is a nothing but 24. And similarly, option D says that is 2 power 5, which is a nothing but 32. Okay, so when we took the options thing, so it is giving different options, so we are 100% safe with respect to this, right? Yes. So the first most important thing that you should understand here is, so when we are taking from this particular node, so there are total 6 chances, right? So among those 6, I need any combination which are having exactly 2, right? Yes. So how we can get them? So the simple thing is this only, right? The combinational trick. So 6 into 5 into 4 factorial divided by 4 factorial into, okay, sorry, 4 factorial into, so 4 factorial, 4 factorial will cancel, 2 factorial. So the end result will be 2 ones, 2 threes. So we got 15, right? Yes. So this could be the potential answer, but there is no option, right? Yes. So let us think, did we miss anything, guys? So basically, if you take this particular thing, like if you take one maximum and the other all combinations, or shall we count it? So I think it will be better if we count it, right? Yes. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Okay, so let me count it, guys. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, so we got a total of 13 different 2-2 combinations, right? Yes. Okay, so we are getting 13, right? To be clear, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I think I'm missing something. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 addition, right? So it is a nothing but 5 plus 9. Okay, so 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. So the result is 15. So that's what we are getting, right? Yes. So if it is a 15, okay. So if there are 15 different connections possible, okay. So if there are 15 different connections possible, what is the degree at this point, guys? So the degree will be 15. So is there any other chance that we could get more answer than this, guys? Okay. Okay, so I think rather than selecting the maximum one, if we select only two values, so if we select 1 comma 2, okay, so we mandatorily making 1 comma 2, we can have 3, 4, 5 and 6 as optional, right? So any one of them could exist and could not exist, okay? So what is the possibility, guys? Okay, so what is the possibility for this? So it is a nothing but, so this guy could exist and could not exist. So the chance is a 2, similarly 2, similarly 2, similarly 2. Means present option, present option, present option, present option. So anything is possible. So what is the final value? So 2 into 2 into 2, that is nothing but 2 power, okay, sorry. Okay, sorry, I'm doing in a wrong way, right? So any one of them could exist or could not exist. So we can try it in terms of permutation and combination, right? So it will directly becomes a 4 factorial. Okay, so 4 factorial is nothing but 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. That is nothing but a 24, right? Yes. So with that understanding, you can say C is the correct answer, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, yes. So I hope you got some basic idea, right? So among these all guys, so anyone could exist and could not exist. So if you want me to write down, I can write it also, guys. So 1 or 2 is okay. And the rest all 3, 4, 5 and 6 could exist and could not exist, right? Yes. Okay. So you can take one after the other, slowly one after the other. So one will exist, one will not exist. Okay. Yes. So I think this approach is a bit wrong. So basically you will get 16 only, right? So you will get all zeros. And then you will move up to all ones, right? So the count will be exactly 16. So 16 different things will be possible. Okay. Okay, so at that time, B could be the correct answer. So with this all analysis, I think we can eliminate option A, guys, because 64 is way too far from all our options, right? Yes. So 16 could be the potential thing here. So 16 different ones will be connected. Okay, so in all of them, I'm making 1 comma 2 as mandatory. Okay, so if we take all values, we are getting 15, okay, and if we are taking in this way, we are getting 16, okay. So just give me a second, guys, I'll be cross-checking the answer, okay. Okay, so if we are taking two elements, we are getting 16. So let us take three elements now, guys. So let us assume we will take 1, 2 and 3 as fixed, and the rest all numbers can come and cannot come, okay. So 4, 5, 6, okay. So among this 1, 2, 3, we need to take any two elements, right? Okay. Okay. So among these 1, 2, 3, we can take any two elements. So the combination will be 3C2, right? Yes. So this will result you in 3. And these all guys could have any number, right? So they could exist or they could not exist. So each and every one is having 2, 2, 2. So what is the result here? It is nothing but 2 into 2 into 2. Okay. Okay, so that is a 8, right? Yes. And when we multiply it with 3, we gonna get 24. So here it is matching with 24. Okay, yes. So moving on. So when we took all 6, we got, so let me write it down here, guys. So when we took all 6, I understand that the problem is taking a bit long, but it's a bit complex question, guys, because it's a chain question and it's complex too. Okay, yes. So if we took all numbers, so we got 15, right? Yes. So when we took only two numbers mandatorily, we got how much we got, guys? We got 16, right? Yes. So when we took 1 2 3 and we tried to get the combination, so we got 24. So let us try 1 2 3 4 now. So 1 2 3 4, so means indirectly from these four I need to take any two. So it is a 4C2, right? Yes, which is a nothing but 4 factorial by 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Okay, which is a nothing but 3 into 2, which is a 6. So first I got a 6, and later on it is a 2 into 2, right, indirectly. So it is a 4. So here also we are going to get a 64. So if I take 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4, and the rest 2 are not mandatory, so we can take 24 chances are there. Similarly, let us try for the other also, because we have calculated till here. I think calculating 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will also be good. So it becomes a 5C3, right? Yes. Okay, so 5C3, so it is nothing but a 5 factorial, that is a 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2. So this will cancel, this will cancel. So here we got a 10 and it is 2. So here we will get a 20. So among these all, which is a maximum, guys? So this 24 is maximum and this 24 is maximum. So at the end, 24 is only the result. okay, and when we take three elements or when we take four elements, those two guys are going to have the maximum value, guys. Okay, so I think this proof will be enough for you, right? Yes. So I know I took more time and I did some silly mistakes also while solving it, but I understand that now you got a clear idea with respect to this question, right? Yes. So now let us move to the next part of the question. Okay, so I think it is a direct 6-mark thing, guys. Okay, so this is the next part of the question. Okay, so now what they are asking is, so the same question, and now what they are asking is the number of connected components in G. Okay, so what are connected components exactly, guys? Okay, so if you recall, this is a type of repeated thing, right? So in our first question, I can take out the paper here. Okay, so if you observe here carefully, so each and everything is connected which is greater than 2, right? So if a subset, sorry, if a set or if a node is having a degree 2, so basically if it is having 2 numbers inside, it is going to be connected for sure. So basically this whole big one is with 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So if any particular vertex name is having this many number of elements, it is going to be connected for sure, right? Yes. So this is our first component. When it comes to the next part, okay, we are left out with one empty set. Later on, we are left out with 1, 2, I'm taking with respect to 6 example only, guys. 3, 4, 5, 6. So in total, this is one component, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth. So in total, 8 components are possible. So option A is wrong because it is saying 6, this is saying 8. This is saying again, I think so, it is 2 power 4, right? Yes, it is 16. So this is also wrong. And similarly, it is saying 2 power A, sorry. What's our value, guys? It is 6, right? Okay, yeah, the result is 8, but the value is 6, right? Here I need to 2 power 3, right? It will be 8, okay? Yes, similarly, when it comes to here, it is a 2 power 6 divided by 6. Okay, the result will be coming in 10 point something. So at the end, B is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So this question is a complex question. I do understand, guys. But I think most of the students got some idea, right? So how exactly you can solve these type of questions. I do understand the video is a bit lengthy, like around 16 minutes or 17 minutes now. But you got an idea, right? And the most challenging question in among these three is this question, guys. Because it forced me to check each and every value, right? And I'm really interested in solving these type of questions more, right? Yes. Okay. So now you got an idea, right? So how you can analyze these questions. And never go with the crazy sets, guys. So basically here, as he forced me to take n greater than or equal to 6, I took a 6. Or else I'll be taking 3 and 2 or 4, guys. Got it? Yes. So at that time, the question will be really easy. Because now we went up to 6 only, it became tough. Okay? Yes. So now you got an idea, right? Yes. Okay. So I think everyone got a 100% clear idea with respect to this question. Okay? Yes. So how you need to do in the examination also, you got some idea, right? Yes. Okay. And these type of questions are not that much meant for examination, guys. Because in examination, under pressure, solving these questions are really tough. Okay, I do agree for it. Okay, yes. Okay. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.